Hello, everybody, and welcome back to some more Spyro the Dragon, Ripto's Rage. Or, in other countries, it's called Gateway to Glimmer, I forgot to mention that. And in this episode, we are going to be taking on a couple worlds here, and being able to unlock the ability to swim. And, before we can do that, we have to do this world right here. This world, I hate. I hate this world. It's probably my least favorite world in the entire game. If not, it's one of them. And it's very iconic for something that I think some of you guys might find pretty funny. I do. And although I hate this world, when I hear anything that sounds like this, it makes me want to play it. Anyways, let's jump into Colossus and you'll see what I mean. Okay, guys, so here we are in Colossus. Each world has a little intro like that. And this is actually the first world we're doing besides Glimmer, so you'll get to see how things can be different in different worlds. So this world is inhabited by brothers, which are, you know, monks, I suppose. And basically this world has been inhabited by these monsters, and we need to defeat them for them. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. We don't have to actually kill all the enemies here, but that's the basic story of Colossus. Now, I hate this world, as I've said, and we'll be able to unlock the ability to swim here with just a couple of gems, because we only need 500. But basically the gist of this is you talk to these. I'm not going to let them speak because they don't really have too much to say. And they do. They're singing. The why. It's so iconic for this world. And it's very annoying, but I find it funny. That's not why I don't like this world. I just dislike this world. There's really no reason for it. I just don't like Colossus. That's just me. But it is also the name of a golem that I used in Pokemon. On the same team that I used my the same team that I used my shiny Crobat, Glimmer. Now, some of you might be familiar with Colossus from the Platinum Wedlock. That is not named after this world, but it was named after a roller coaster, as any of you that saw that series would know. But I did reference the fact that I used a golem at one point named Colossus. And you'll probably get to see him at some point if I ever show my main file. I'm sure I will here eventually. It's definitely on the list of things to show off. And who knows, maybe you'll see that before you even see this. I don't know if I'll get around to that or not. But here's one of these portals that I was telling you about. And what Zoe's going to tell you is that you need 11 enemies to unlock it. And I basically explained that last episode. However, we had already unlocked the portal. But in this case, we still have to kill 11 enemies. So we should be able to do that here. I think you have to. Yeah, okay, so you got to go this way. Yeah, I forgot. It's been a while. But you might see these little statues around here, like that guy down here. And these are used for an orb mini quest, I guess you could say, which we'll get to when we get to it. It's a little backtracking for this world. You can't do it before you get to the ability to do it, which you'll know what I mean. We'll just keep collecting the gems and going through the world. Grab this extra life over here and talk to this guy, and he'll levitate this platform for us. Sorry, Curtis. I think that was what your name was. I didn't really pay attention. I just want to get it done because, you know, it's hard to commentate when they're speaking. That's kind of the problem that I was concerned about with doing Sly. Most of the game is very dialogue heavy, and the characters do have voices, which would be kind of hard to commentate because you can't skip it, and I would never want to because Sly is very story driven. This is more or less nonsense that they say, which is the reason that I skip it. It's not anything to do with the story whatsoever. There's really not a story in Spyro. Like, there's a little bit of a story. Ripto's taking over. You gotta collect all the talismans to defeat him. But other than that, it's just collect everything and have a good time, which is, you know, what Spyro is. But Sly is much different. I would love to play Sly at some point, but I'll figure it out eventually. So here's 11 enemies that'll unlock those portals. And that thing right there, you can't break that with charging or fire. You have to break that with a rocket. I dropped some frames there, if you saw that. I don't know why that happened, but it should be alright. So that's all of the gems on this side. There's nothing on those little platforms, but yeah, you can jump down there if you want and ride that along. But there's nothing down there, if I recall. So I'm gonna try and double jump to get back. Oh, I have don't have to. Yeah, this is a spring portal. This is different than the ones we've been seeing, and it'll basically shoot you upwards, which is how you get all the way up here. And we can get some gems up there if you don't fall off like I did. Let's spring upwards and land correctly. There we go. And you can get on top of the building up here, and that is how you get to that orb mission that I was talking about. So we want to face the other way this time, and we can get up here. And there are lots of gems, and we can go ahead and go inside this cave on the other side here, and we can grab our first orb mini quest for the world of Colossus. So let's go ahead and talk to the professor here. And something ran away there, so let's see what he has to say.
Thank goodness you scared that evil spirit away, but now it will hide in the statues. If you were to flame all 10 statues, I'm sure you would chase it away for good.
Yeah, so basically, it'll do a little summarization of what you're supposed to do here, and the difficulty meter. The difficulty meter I've never really used. None of these missions are hard. There is a couple missions that are really difficult, but not in Spyro 2, if I can recall. The only mission that comes to my mind that's really hard is in Spyro 3, which hopefully I'll be able to showcase that when we do Spyro 3, which I plan to. So now you can see all the statues are green. So just need to go ahead and flame them all. And here's this rocket that I was talking about, or firework, I might have said. All you gotta do is flame that, and it will always hit the target. And it'll blow that up, and lots of gems are inside. So you definitely need those gems to 100% Colossus, as with all worlds. So I'm gonna try and get over here. You don't have to double jump to do that. You can just glide right over. But there's no gems over here. Don't worry. It'll just be a little shortcut to go ahead and get down to this statue, because I believe this is the first statue. I don't think there are any back here, but I'm gonna check just in case. There might be, I don't remember exactly. It doesn't seem to be the case. Yeah, there are none. So basically just fly back down here and then you can start from the beginning. And make sure you don't miss any, because you can definitely miss some and it can be a little annoying. They're pretty hard to miss though. This one I've missed a couple of times just because it's kinda in the corner here. But once you get off all 10 of them, it'll teleport you back to the professor and then you can continue. This is definitely the fastest way to beat the world, I would think. Obviously, I'm no speedrunner of the game. I've thought about trying to speedrun it, and who knows, maybe that'll be a live stream content one day. Who knows, it could be interesting, but I can't even do the spring. Yeah, I talk about being able to do that, whatever. I'd probably do any percent, not 100%, just because any percent's shorter, and you can do more attempts in an hour, because you know what I mean. It'd be fun. It's something to experiment with one day, potentially, who knows. So, there's a statue up here that I missed, which is funny, because it's right next to the professor. And, let's see. Let's finish off the world and grab our talisman really quick. So, if we come talk to this guy, he'll tell us what's going on.
Even though I'm a vegetarian, I think you should kill that Yeti. He's pretty tough, though. In fact, I'm not so sure you're up to it.
Yeah, so we got ourselves a little boss fight. We gotta fight this Yeti. Now, this is definitely not a boss fight. Hey, at least we didn't have to do it ourselves.
I thought the Yeti was tougher than that. I guess he was all bark. Anyway, I was just guarding our sacred talisman to make sure the Yeti didn't eat it.
Yeah, so, yeah, he was just guarding and he wasn't afraid or anything. But yeah, we get the Colossus talisman, which is a little brother. So, yeah, that's pretty sweet. Alright, so, let's grab the gems inside here. And if you were just a casual player and didn't want to 100%, you could leave now. But if you go outside the window right here, you might be thinking, why would you want to go out here? Well, there's a whole other part of the world over here. And there's also a statue. Just spray it. There we go. Alright, so I'll get the rest of the statues in a minute. But if you come over here, you can do a fun little mini game. It's kind of annoying, but I think some of you guys might enjoy this. It's definitely interesting to somebody who has never played the game before. But somebody that's played it over and over again, you don't really like to replay these missions too often. Like, I like most of them, but this one's kind of annoying. But we'll get right into it. We're going to play a game of hockey, so let's talk to him.
Ah, Spyro, welcome. We have found that hockey is a peaceful and calming sport. Would you like to join in a match against our goalkeeper?
Which is funny, because I never really thought about it like that, but they find hockey to be a peaceful and calming sport. It's definitely not. So we have 2 minutes to score 5 goals against their goalie, which is easier said than done. It can definitely be kind of finicky, but we'll see. I'll show you what I'm talking about. So he'll hit that, and he's not going to try and score against us, so we don't have anything to worry about. We just have to get 5 of these pucks into the goal, which isn't so bad. It's really easy if you just get him to the left and then shoot it to the right like that. If you do it right, that is, because I just messed it up. But, you know, it's not so bad. We only have 5 minutes to do it. We should be able to handle it. Oh, 2 minutes to do it. There we go. That's one. That's two. Three. Four. And we're cutting it close with five. But hey, we did it. So yeah, I just wanted to cut that part out because it's kind of repetitive, obviously. And that is our first orb for the World of Colossus. And you can get another one by doing this. So we have to play again, but this time it's one-on-one. You gotta score 5 goals against the red skater before he gets 5 goals on you. Could be easier said than done. I've lost this a couple times. It's not the hardest thing in the world, but he can definitely be a challenge for sure. So you want to go ahead and get 5 goals against the red guy. You don't want him to get the goals in on you. So you can just take the puck by spraying him with fire. Spraying him with fire. Shooting fire at him. Whatever. So he got a goal on us. Oh well. Knock him out, because that's totally fair, you know, fair, you know. You don't want to be spraying fire on your opponents in real hockey. But he's going to get another goal on us, because our goalie's horrible. No, he's not, actually, so spray him. I can't grab the puck. I'm so bad. Whatever, he got another one. This is going to be fantastic, isn't it? Okay, let's knock him out. Keep knocking him out, because that's totally awful. And grab the puck. Okay. So he will knock the puck right out of you, if he can, but we got a goal. That's one down. Two. Three. Four. And number five coming in hot. Aw, maybe not. That's fine. We'll get it this time. Number five coming in hot. He only got 3 points on us. Not so bad. And we'll get the second orb for the World of Colossus. And that is it for the hockey. Thankfully, it's not as fun as it might look. If it looks fun, maybe it doesn't. I don't know. It's not. But let's go ahead and finish up Colossus really quick. We're almost done here. There's not too much left to do, just the statues and a couple of gems, which you might be wondering, where are those statues at? Well, there's one over there I just missed, of course. Let's grab that statue. And then let's go ahead and spring upwards. And you can go ahead and fly where that brick fell on the Yeti. And there are some gems up here, including our final statue. So let's go ahead and grab the last of the gems before we spray that statue. Because that'll be all 400 gems and the last orb. I'm missing another statue, which it should be, like, right here. Where is it? How do you miss a statue? I'm missing it somewhere so obvious right now. Let's go ahead and find it. It should just be... I'm not exactly sure where it's at, to be honest with you. I'm missing just one. Where could it be? I've got a good idea, actually. Oh, yeah, duh. If you recall earlier on in the level, there was one inside. I normally miss this one, but it's just right inside. Right here. So let's grab that final statue, and it'll take us back to the professor.
Well done, Spyro.
Yes, well done indeed. And let's grab the final orb. That's 3 out of 3 orbs, the talisman, all 400 gems. That's Colossus complete. Awesome. Let's head outside. So yeah, that thing that you just saw right there was a little end slate that they do when you leave a level for the first time. They're pretty funny and comedic at times, but what you saw right there as we leave is what happens when you leave a world. It tallies up your gems and adds them to your current total. So, now that we have those gems, we can buy the ability to swim, which is required for the next level that we're going to do, Idle Springs. So let's pay all 500 gems, and we can now swim. So it's simple, just hold charge when you're in water, and you can swim around like this. Now, there is a variety of glitches involved with swimming, which I guess I'll showcase one just for fun. But let's first grab the gems that are underwater here, because they are required for the completion of Summer Forest, of course. We're not going to be able to 100% Summer Forest yet. Actually, we are. You're not supposed to be able to 100% it until you get the ability to climb. But with the ability to swim, there's a glitch you can do to access the place that you're supposed to be able to climb at before you're supposed to be able to climb. So now we can access the next part of Summer Forest. We don't have to do Idle Springs yet, but we are going to do it next just because it's in order. And if you go ahead and check the guidebook, you can go ahead and see what we have done so far. We have 100% Glimmer, 100% Colossus, and 31% done with Summer Forest. We can finish Summer Forest now, though, like I said, using a glitch, which I'm going to do just so we don't have to do as much backtracking. But if this is your first time playing, don't try and do these. Just play the game as normal. It's definitely a lot of fun. I've just done it so many times that I like to shake it up a bit. So you can hit these switches to access the next part of Summer Forest.
Well on your way, Spyro. Keep collecting talismans to help us defeat Ripto before he can take over Avalar.
Yeah, so she's just saying, and keep collecting the orbs and stuff, and they help us, you know, get back to the dragon world at the end. The orbs are definitely used for opening up portals. Certain amount of orbs are used to unlock different worlds and stuff. I'm not gonna go inside that world quite yet, although I almost fell inside of it. Let's grab that extra life, couple of gems here. Hunter over there will change your camera to active mode if you didn't do it at the start like I did. It's what active mode does, I don't really explain it, but if you turn left, the camera will follow you, versus you have to turn the camera yourself. It's definitely a lot more convenient, and that's how I like to play it. So, we gotten all the gems in this little area right here. There's a whole bunch of different worlds. We'll go over that. But let's go ahead and grab the gems in this little section. And you can see money bags. We have to pay him again. Once again, you can glitch it so you don't have to pay him. But what's behind that wall is another world. Another one of my least favorite worlds. But we'll get to that eventually. And over here is the boss fight for Summer Forest. We can't access that yet until we have collected all of the talismans. So we have to do all the worlds before we can access that. But that's okay because we're not going to be doing that till we're done here anyways. I'm going to pay money bags just because you can. 400 gems, yeah. I'm going to pay him really quick. I know I don't have to, like I said, but I'm still going to do everything the way you're supposed to, regardless with glitches. So by paying him, it'll take up your gems, but there are some gems back here that you need for the completion of Summer Forest, as usual. And there's a world, one of my least favorites, arguably worse than Colossus. We have Aquaria Towers, which we're not going to be doing yet. We're going to be doing that later on, of course. We're going to do Idle Springs next, but I do want to go ahead and complete Summer Forest while I can. So, let's go ahead into the next area, which is over to the left here. There are some gems, and our first portal that is unlocked by orbs, which is actually should be unlocked now. I don't know how many it takes.
Nice work, Spyro.
Yeah, nice work, Spyro. The orbs you're carrying activates this, and this is our first speedway. Speedways are different than the normal worlds. We'll get into that when we actually do the speedway, but there's one in every home world, and I believe there's two in the next one. But yeah, there's always at least one, and the speedways are really fun, and they're definitely different than your usual world. So, there's actually an orb for Summer Forest hidden behind here, but you can't get it. If you see it right there on the towards the right, you can see it behind that door, but you can't access it unless that door's open. So, you have to jump up here, and you're actually supposed to do this. This isn't a glitch, and that's how you get this orb back here. And a couple of gems? No, just an orb. So we get our orb for this area. That's another orb. I think the second for Summer Forest. Indeed it is. And that is all of the orbs and gems scattered around. So this is all you're actually able to do in Summer Forest as of right now. Except that one area that we didn't go, that I tried to access the last episode. So let's go ahead over there and do that really quick. That one area. I'm going to meet you all the way back at the start of Summer Forest. Okay, guys, back over here by the Portal of Glimmer, there is a little pool that you can swim in that you might have noticed at the beginning. So if we go ahead and jump down here, there are some gems, and there is an orb all the way at the end of this area. This is the most that you can do in Summer Forest without the ability to climb. However, I am going to complete it now, so we don't have to backtrack, by using a glitch, like I said. Let me know how you guys feel about that. I would just do a regular Let's Play, 100%, doing it the way you're supposed to. This saves a lot of time and less backtracking and stuff. And if you're playing along for the first time, you can just backtrack when you do get the ability to climb without pulling off a glitch like I do. So that's the third orb of Summer Forest. Now, how you're going to pull off this glitch is really interesting. This glitch is called the Swim in Air glitch. And how it works is it utilizes your ability to swim outside of the world when you're not supposed to be able to swim. And in turn, it makes you fly, basically, infinitely. And it lets you access areas that you're not supposed to access. Okay, guys, I was actually trying to do it wrong. I was thinking about when I was doing it in a different homeworld, which we'll get to that eventually. But what you want to do is up and square at the same time on this ledge. It's kind of hard to do, but if you just do it right, you can be swimming in air, which will let you basically access places that you're not supposed to get to at this point, which basically is the ability to climb, which is what we're trying to skip, just to show you guys for fun, I suppose. Alright, there we go. Okay, so I finally got it. So now you can see I'm swimming in the air. You're not supposed to be able to do this. It took me a couple attempts, but that's how you do that. So, now that we can do this, obviously you can do a lot of things that you're not supposed to be able to do at this point in the game. And the only thing we're going to do this for is so we can do the place where you're supposed to climb at. So if you just go ahead and swim outside of the castle and all the way over here to where Laura's standing, where you can climb, you can get up here. So, now that we're up here, we can get all the gems and the orb. So we're 4 out of 4 orbs, which you're not supposed to be able to do yet. And we are all of the gems as of right now. And that's Summer Forest complete. So I like to do that just so we don't have to backtrack. So now that we've done that, let's go ahead and find our way back to Hidden Old Idle Springs so we can continue where we're supposed to be now. And just flying through the world. The game's very glitchy, obviously, but you don't have to exploit these. So now let's do Idle Springs. Let's fly inside. Okay, here we are in Idle Springs. So I dislike this world as well. You might be like, why do you like the game? Well, just the beginning levels I really don't like that much. So, except Glimmer. Glimmer's pretty sweet. So, here we are in Idle Springs. So, basically you want to do this after you unlock the ability to swim, because obviously there's a whole bunch of water around here. And there's quite a bit of stuff that you can do with the ability to swim. So let's start by doing that and grabbing all the gems and stuff that you can grab underwater here. There's also an orb that you can get down here, and that's, you know, very good reason to get the ability to swim first. As much as I just like Colossus, I definitely recommend doing it first, because that gives you enough gems to be able to unlock the ability to swim. So, this should be all of the gems around this area. I'm pretty sure I didn't miss any. Alright, I missed one. These vases are just the same as the regular vases on the top, and you obviously can't breathe fire down here. You breathe bubbles. So, let's go ahead in here and do our first orb mini quest for Idle Springs. Already, we're jumping right into the gate. So, this one's a little strange. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to give a very good guide on this, but I guess we can try. So, let's talk to this guy.
I've been locked in here with all our tools, and the giant idle heads won't let the workers in unless we can solve the 3 puzzles they've given us.
So, we need to solve 3 puzzles, and the first puzzle is to turn all these blocks yellow. So, after that, we can ask the foreman for help. So, when you jump on one, it will change them. So, what I like to do is just keep jumping back and forth, because, like, I've never gotten a really good way of doing this puzzle before. I just don't know how to do it. I've never known how to do it. I just jump on this blocks all the time, and hopefully grab the right combinations. So, it looks like this would do it? No? That's all of them but one. Okay. What if I jumped on this one again? It resets it. Okay. I'm trying to figure it out as we go along. Let's do this one. I'm so ashamed of myself that I don't know how to do this. This should turn all 3 of these. Yeah, it did. Okay, so, and then this one to do it. Awesome. Alright, that's done. Yeah, we did it. So we don't get an orb for that. We need to do the other 2 puzzles that he's talking about. So we need to go ahead and meet him at the next destination, which we'll do as we progress along in the level. So it's definitely good to do this right away instead of backtracking, because now we'll be able to meet up with him as we continue on in the level. So, let's go ahead and talk to this guy. at the start and see what this world's about. So, basically, the idols we were carving have come to life, and they've locked us out of our temples and stole our food. So now, we need to go ahead and deal with this idol problem, because apparently they come to life. I love these guys because they're like roasting marshmallows and they're adorable. So, the idea is you knock them out and then the foremans will go ahead and unlock the doors. But, there's also another orb mission over here. So, if we go ahead and talk to this guy, we need to feed this idol head. The idol's hungry, but he won't be satisfied till he's swallowed 10 fish. And he doesn't like red fish. So, we need to go ahead and give him, if you flame the fish in. But if you flame in red fish, he will not be pleased with you. Like that, he'll spit them all out. And you gotta start over. So, it's basically, keep focused and don't get trigger happy. You get trigger happy, he won't be happy. So, let's spray in the blues, spray in the oranges. This one's gonna be a red one. No? Let's flame him in. I messed this up a lot. You need to keep focused. Like, right there, my finger almost slipped. Keep your finger off of the circle button, and only slam it down when you see something that's not red. If you're seeing red, don't get mad, basically. Alright, red. Red again. Okay. He's getting hungry, guys. We need to feed him. Orange. Blue. Orange. That one took a while, but there we go. 10 fishes, and that'll be feeding that guy. So there we go. Oh, that's one of the puzzles. That's right. Okay, I forgot about that completely. I thought that was just a completely separate orb mission. Never mind. So let's go ahead and grab this gem. And that guy just talked to us saying thank you or whatever, I think. So let's go ahead and charge this guy down. Since he's holding a shield like that, you can't flame him. You have to charge him down. And this guy is bullying this guy. We should probably just leave him there, but we'll save him because we have to. Sorry, no glitches involved with this one. Actually, there probably is something. I don't know, but I don't know. We'll save him because we have to. All right, let's charge these down and continue along. Okay, so there's some gems in here. Zoe is Apus. Actually, Zoe wants to talk to us. Let's just avoid her completely. She's going to tell us that these guys can't be flamed, as if we didn't already figure that out ourselves, because, you know, we already defeated him. I don't know why they felt the need to teach us that, but they do, regardless, because I think it's just trial and error. You flame him, you're going to see it's not going to work. You're not just going to keep flaming him over and over again. You know, it's kind of common sense. Oh no, it didn't work. Kill him. There we go. Simple. Alright, we got ourselves another life, which is going to be great. As you can see, if you got a keen eye, I lost a life trying to do that swimming in air glitch back there, but that's okay. That's fodder. Yeah, that's his fodder. Okay, I was gonna say, what is that? It looks strange. Either way, we unlocked this door, so now we go into this little cave area. Grabbing some gems. Okay, let's grab some more. So many gems. Gonna be very useful to pay money bags, because we owe him our life, apparently. Because he's very greedy. That's where he gets his name from. Alright, go fix the door, man. You're slow. Let's go. This reminds me of that gem cutter at the beginning of the series. Okay. Grab these. And go on to our next puzzle after we kill this guy. The final puzzle is right here. This level is pretty short if you go through it really quickly. This puzzle is also really strange. I never figured out how to do this one either, but I just jump on them. So jump on the stones in the correct order. I normally just random it. So it's green, not the moon. Yep, and he'll keep telling you the same thing over. So let's do green. All right, let's do this. Probably not orange. Let's do blue. Oh, it's a pattern. No, it's not. It's orange. Never mind. Whatever. And it's always the same, I'm pretty sure. So, let's go with this one, and I'm pretty sure it's silver. Yes, it is. Okay, and then blue. And that is it. Congratulations, we've gotten an orb. And he'll take us all the way back to the start, because he's a jerk. But now we gotta go all the way through the level again. No big deal. That's the first orb for Idle Springs. And we have to fly all the way back through the level. Sorry about that. That's actually more efficient to do that after you finish the level, because then you can go ahead and break this chest that's up here, which I'll show you guys how to do that. But anyways, I'll cut back to the end of the level. Okay, back where we were. Let's spray this guy up. He'll let us inside. We probably should have done that first, so it would already have been opened. But it's okay. It's not that big of a deal. So, now that he'll open that up, that'll be the end of the level. So, if we go ahead and talk to this guy, we'll grab our talisman.
You're pretty tough. If you ever want a permanent job, we've got a place for you here. For the moment, I want you to have this talisman.
Yeah, so let's grab the Idle Springs Talisman. I love this one. It's a little idol head. I love the way it looks. I think it's really cool. It'd be really cool to, I know the games are old and it'll never happen, but, like, talismans, like, all 14 talismans, you could, like, buy them on Fangamer or something. That would be amazing. I would definitely buy all 14 talismans in a heartbeat and, like, hang them up somewhere. I think it'd be really cool. So, if you take this path, this is our next orb mission, but there's some gems up here that you can grab first, which I'm gonna do before we go down there. Down there is the next orb mission that I was just talking about. And it's a pretty fun one. It can be a little difficult if you've never done it before, but I should be able to do it first try. Now that I've said that, I'm gonna be ashamed of myself if I don't, because I'll feel like I let everybody down, but whatever. Dog's being a horrible puppy right now. Oh, okay, guys, sorry about that. So let's go ahead and grab the rest of these gems like I was talking about. And I believe the rocket that opens that chest at the beginning is over here. Actually, no, it's not. That's right. Yeah, it is. Never mind. I don't remember. I think it is. Not too sure about that. So let's go ahead and grab these and get the firework. Yeah, there it is. Okay, so this firework opens that big chest at the beginning. So we can spray that. What? Why isn't it lighting? That's so strange. There we go. Okay, I lit it, so I can go back there at the beginning. Oh, I don't want to fly off of here. Okay, I didn't want to fly off because I want to go back to where I was and do that orb mission. So this one's really enjoyable. It's very fast-paced, and you'll see what I mean here. So let's go ahead and jump down here. There's some gems down here. I'll go ahead and grab the gems first so they don't get in our way. You'll know exactly what I'm talking about once you see what we've got to do here. They're a little bit distracting. You'll know exactly what I'm talking about. So let's go ahead and grab all of these. Yeah, so this portal is unlocked by enemies, like the spring portal was in Colossus, and like the flying portal was in Glimmer. So I believe that's all the gems up here. Yeah, so the idea is you want to knock all these guys down in one go. So it's a supercharged portal. Is that I believe that's what they're called. Yeah, this is supercharged. So I believe there are some gems still around here, and they're very distracting. So you can't break these things with your normal charge, but the supercharge makes it so you can be super powerful when you charge, basically. But you also go super fast. So let's try and go Sanic fast and hit all of these in one go following the path. And that's all six. That's all you need to do. And that will free all of them. They can do their little rain dance for this tiki guy. And I believe it blows him up. I don't remember. Let's see. Yeah, he's gone now. And the hula girl, Stella, will be like, look at that. The hula girl's rain dance blew him up. And we'll get our second orb, which is the final orb of Idle Springs. Only two in this world. So all we're missing is some gems now. This is a pretty short world, like I said at the beginning. So back where the portal is at the exit, you will be able to grab a couple of gems. And then we can fly all the way down to where we blew that thing up with fireworks, and that will be the rest of the gems for this level. So, and for the episodes, let's go ahead and grab these guys over to the side here. Don't want to miss them, and then fly over here. You can get in this water. It won't drag you down or anything, but you gotta grab these before you do. And then you'll basically fly right out of this waterfall. And by doing that, it'll take you back to the start of the episode. No, it's not start of the episode, start of the level. And you can get the gems that fell in the water, because you don't want to miss these. I have missed them before, because I never really thought about it. And then, if you jump up there, you can fly down, but if you just jump like this, Sparks normally gets them for you. And that'll be Idle Springs complete. Once again, we've completed yet another level. We've done Idle Springs, Summer Forest, and Colossus this episode. It was definitely a pretty eventful episode, and the next episode we're going to be going in deeper to Summer Forest, maybe doing the Speedway and a couple more levels, and we should be able to do the boss in the episode after that. So with that being said, I hope you enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, it helps out a great deal, and if you want to see more Pokemon Weblocks or Spyro the Dragon, feel free to subscribe, and I'll catch you guys next time. Thanks for watching.